Hi, my name is Manuela. I'm from Argentina, but I grew up all my life in Jakarta, Indonesia. I'm currently studying at Harvard University. I'm studying computer science, and I'm also using Talk Abroad to study French. In Talk Abroad, I completed 4 conversations, and each were 30 minutes. So definitely having a French course using Talk Abroad helped me learn the language in a different way, in a new perspective. Just having someone from a different country, not even being France, maybe Togo or Morocco, it was so interesting to hear their perspectives about their culture. The topics we touched in my French class were often about social justice, the importance of language, maybe traveling and cultures and communities in their home countries. So I think it was so interesting to learn more through that perspective. And compared to other classes that did not use Talk Abroad, I felt that this course almost gave me the opportunity to immerse myself more in French and in the countries of these people that I was talking to myself. And it also taught me how to use the conversation in a day-to-day way. Because every time I chose a different conversation partner, and I especially tried to make the different conversation partner from a different country, because I wanted to see if I could talk with someone who is maybe from Togo or from France or from Canada. I thought it was really important to try to apply myself to all these different countries and definitely learn more from the people as well. Going into the conversation, whoever I had a conversation with was always friendly, always kind, always patient if I made a mistake, and always willing to help me or just to give me the same amount of respect when I asked a question. They definitely asked it back to me. So it definitely eased any nerves I had or any anxieties before going into the conversation. They made me feel super welcomed and just willing to have a conversation with me as well. Some tips and tricks that I'd give someone who's starting Talk Abroad. Definitely, I would say always come with maybe a little bit of preparation. If it's those 10 questions you want to ask this person, or if it's just even a conversation topic in mind. And secondly, the best tip I'd give is just relax, and the conversation is meant to be something that's there to help you, and people are so kind and they're just going to be willing to help you no matter what or have this conversation with you.
Est-ce que tu aimes être traductrice?
En fait, j'aime bien, mais ce n'est pas ma passion.
Oui.
En fait, c'est un travail qui est assez difficile.
Oui,
il est difficile de trouver des contrats pour... Donc, là, si je fais le travail de traduction, c'est pour pouvoir économiser, pour... ouvrir un restaurant, parce que ma passion, c'est la cuisine.
Oh, OK.
Donc, oui.
Donc, est-ce que tu veux ouvrir un restaurant?
Oui, j'aimerais bien ouvrir un restaurant, un fast-food.
Oh, OK. De quel type de fast-food?
Est-ce que tu connais les French tacos?
Non, pas. Mais...
Attends, je te montre une photo. Et j'adore les French tacos et j'aimerais bien ouvrir un restaurant où on ne vend que ça. C'est comme ça, en fait.
Oh, oui.
Oui. Et c'est vraiment délicieux.
Oui. Il semble délicieux.
Et toi, qu'est-ce que tu veux faire dans le futur? Est-ce que tu sais déjà?
Maintenant, non, je ne sais pas. Je ne suis pas sûre, mais...
Oui, mais tu as tout le temps de réfléchir.
Oui, j'espère que oui.
D'accord. Je pense qu'il faut qu'on parle des films, c'est ça?
Oui, j'ai une question de te demander ou de vous demander sur les films, la musique en général.
D'accord.
Donc, ma première question est-ce que vous avez un artiste au genre de musique, au film, aux chansons préférées?
C'est difficile de choisir, hein?
Oui.
Mais j'aime beaucoup de genres de musique. J'aime le R&B, j'aime le soul, J'aime les musiques afro, enfin les musiques africaines.
Oui.
Et il y a beaucoup de choses, enfin, mm-hmm. Il y a beaucoup de genres de musique que j'aime. Et
Ouais.
pour mes chanteurs préférés, c'est difficile de choisir.
Ouais.